Marcia from Beauty Pie and
Whitney from Flowerbox.
We're really excited to have done an interview today. So tune in and listen. Tips, tricks.
Everything.
So we have this first question. Tell me why it's so good to surround yourself with flowers.
But flowers are like one of the single things in the world, like a material thing that can actually improve your mood. It is filled with emotion. It is filled with love. If someone sent you flowers, those flowers aren't just flowers. They're symbols of someone thinking about you, someone taking time for you, someone, whatever the message was, I love you, I'm sorry, I miss you. And it means more than anything material to me that you can send to connect with people. So flowers to me are connection. Flowers are also, you know, self-care. So it's, you're feeling down, you buy yourself flowers. I mean, listen to the Miley song, which couldn't be more poignant. It's like, I can buy myself flowers. And like that act of buying yourself flowers, it's saying I'm worth it.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. I completely agree. How do you decide which flowers you're going to send to someone yourself?
Well, for me, seasonal is like key. It's like food. If you eat food that's not in season, it tastes terrible. And same with flowers. You know, I would never send you peonies now because peonies aren't in season. So I think respecting the seasons is important. For me, it's always my, I have seasonal favorites. So it's peonies in the late spring. Right now it's ranunculus, which are amazing. Oh, yeah. You know, or I think it's also depending on who you're sending it to and what you're trying to convey. Obviously, if it's a little baby boy that's born, sending, which I hate gender stereotypes, but sending like baby blue hyacinth, or so it depends sort of why you're sending flowers. But seasonal is always key.
I never thought about that in terms of seasonality and food and seasonality and flowers, but it's so true, isn't it? You just can't get the good stuff in the wrong season. What are your favorite flowers then to have at home in April?
In April, I mean, I would say it's like Eastery. So like daffodils and paper whites and any of those spring flowers. Hyacinth, anything really fragrant, and spring fragrant spring flowers are just so amazing. Fabulous. You're like, this actually exists in nature and it's perfect.
It's incredible. It's like a jewel.
Really?
Right? It's like the jewel that comes out of the ground.
And then we all try to copy it. It's like, you know, we try to copy it with fragrance. We try to copy it, but it's like, it's a perfect thing.
Yeah. Could you give us a good tip for making cut flowers last longer?
Well, I was so impressed, Marcia, that you know all the tips to make flowers. Cut at a diagonal. Yeah. It increases water absorption. Change the water every day. Just change the water every day. They will last twice as long. No direct sunlight. It's like fruit. I mean, so much like fruit. Like
What about leaves? Can the leaves be in the water or do you need
no.
to keep?
Yep. Clean them up. Very good. Look,
your flower expert.
Yeah. Remove the leaves under the water line. They drink the water. They take the nutrients from the water. They steal them from the flower. Hydrangeas, you dip them in water. Do you know that?
No.
If you dip the heads in water, because they drink out of their buds. So if
okay.
you like fill a sink full of water, dip your hydrangea in them, let them sit for like 45 seconds.
Okay.
And you lift them out and they revitalize.
What? Did not know
yes.
that.
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to be doing that. Thank you very much. That's great. Okay. Let's talk about beauty.
Yes.
And your beauty routine. You're looking fabulous.
Thank you.
You're obviously
all
very
beauty
chic.
Pie. All very beauty pie How, products. I love beauty pie.
It's working for you. Describe your relationship with the world of beauty. So are you an enthusiast, a novice, or a fanatic?
See, I would not, I'm not any of those really. I'm sort of a beauty purist.
Oh.
And I feel like you're back to what you were saying about clothes. I feel like having a beauty uniform for me just sort of simplifies everything
Every
else. Yeah, it just sort of, it's one thing I don't have to worry about. So I'm not like a huge experimenter, but I love quality. And I like with everything back to flowers, whether it's food, I would so much rather have a few things and have them be really good than have a million things that are sort of crappy. And I love like the quality of your products though, but that's what speaks to me. It's like the simplicity and the quality. It's like pure ingredients. Back to, I like single stem flowers. I like tomato and mozzarella. That's it. I don't like complex things. And I feel like Beauty Pie, one of the reasons I love it and the brand resonates so much with me, both in the aesthetic and with the product, is like the simplicity, just the purity and the simplicity. It's just good quality
stuff.
No BS.
Yes. Yeah. You don't have to switch all the time when you have great stuff.
Exactly.
There's just not that urge. No hole to fill. Your biggest beauty lightning bolt moment. What has changed your beauty game?
This is so funny. I was reading those on the way here and it made me laugh. So I had just started working at Gucci for Tom Ford. I was like 23. I came from Dallas, Texas. I never knew that people took care of their eyebrows.
Texas.
Like I didn't know people, I didn't know eyebrows were a thing. And Tom, I'd been working for him for like a week and he pulls me down into the showroom. Pat McGrath was down there, who like the amazing makeup artist. And he's like, Pat, can you show this girl how to do her brows? And I was like sort of horrified, but I was also really excited.
Yeah,
I'm like, oh my God, Pat McGrath's doing my brows. So she like gave me the tools, showed me how to brush the brows. Now I'm like, are my brows perfect now? I hope so. Showed me how to do it. Now Tom's like, you need to do this every day. And that was like a lightning, not in a mean way. It was
no,
more
no.
like I'm sharing a secret with you. It wasn't like
yes.
you look terrible. It was more like this is going to change your life. And it changed my life because you're like, oh, a brow is like your face is almost finished. If you have like it's the architecture of the face, as Tom always says. So that was my like lightning bolt beauty moment.
I remember seeing him speak once and he said, he was like a Women's Wear Daily conference, you know, one of those CEO summits or something. And he was the keynote speaker. And he said, someone asked me once why I get this groomed. And he said, I just feel like it's polite.
It's good manners.
Yeah. If I'm going to go out and expose myself to other people, I should look as good as I can. And I thought, yes, I know. You should. And he always is perfect, right? Like he's a different always level of grooming. Perfect.
So, and then I left Tom after almost 20 years and I was like, oh my God, I'm not going to get Tom Ford Beauty. I mean, that was like, obviously there are many reasons that was very, very hard to leave, but I'm like, Tom Ford Beauty is so good and it's going to be like so expensive.
Yes.
And then I discovered your brow thing, which is like almost identical.
I use the angled pencil. Oh yeah, that's
yeah, which is amazing.
So
it's like Tom's angled pencil.
Well,
but no, it is. It works in the same way. And the angle is really...
It might be the same.
Yeah, I know. But the angle is the key. So I'm like, okay, well, that's one thing I don't have to worry about.
The gel is really incredible, too. If you ever need a brow gel, there's a tinted brow gel that we have
called
Archology. It's so good.
Okay. Oh, I can keep upping my brow game. Who knew?
I don't know if they could get much better than they already are, but it's always fun to experiment.
Yeah, well, they can always get better.
Please list the steps in your morning skincare routine in 10 words or less.
Well, I'm like a wash and go girl.
10 words or less.
Wash and go. Moisturize, tinted moisturizer.
Okay, that's it.
Yeah,
great.
Yeah,
fantastic.
Then I put on makeup, but that's like my skin.
Yes.
Yes.
Great.
Yeah.
All right.
Purist. Beauty purist.
Yes. I was going to, dare I ask, SPF?
No, but I'm not.
No.
I know, but SPF is in my tinted moisturizer.
Okay,
and if
yes,
I'm going out,
SPF,
I put
yes,
it. If I'm going out in the sun, I do.
Yeah.
But I also want to get vitamin D, which is also important. So it's like...
You need to take it. Sorry.
Yeah, I take it.
I take it to
my supplement list.
Yes.
I do take it.
Yeah,
it's vital.
Vital.
But
every morning.
I feel like I don't go out in the sun enough here, sadly, in London to... I think tinted moisturizer is enough. But if I'm on holiday, 100% SPF is first thing.
Yes, definitely. Because if you're doing all that anti-aging work, you know, with retinol or vitamin C or whatever, and you don't put sunscreen on, it's just like beating your
head. Do you put it on in London?
Every day.
Like today, like a proper SPF?
Yep.
With yours?
Yes.
Yes, which is excellent.
The 50, yeah. I use the 25 usually during the winter and then the 50 during the spring, summer. The 25 is super moisturizing also, so it's
okay,
really
well,
nice.
I'll try the 25. I felt like the 50 is a bit overkill.
It's a lot for the daytime, and you're right about vitamin D, but you're not going to get enough vitamin D anyway.
No.
From...
No.
Right, so all you're going to get is the damage.
No.
Yeah, I know. So vitamin D is such an important nutrient. I mean, not only for, of course, bones and right skin and health, but also for mood. Now they found that vitamin D, taken regularly, there are receptors in your gut microbiome. And when you have more flora in your microbiome in your gut, it actually changes your mood.
That's incredible.
When you think about people with seasonal depressive disorder, right? When the people who get low light and they get really
depressed.
It's actually because... Their gut.
It's chemical.
Yes.
That is wild.
In the vitamin D is not getting into their body and therefore, but it's all about your gut microbiome.
Everything's about your gut
and
the vitamin D.
It really is.
But even when COVID was happening, like really bad, and they're like, the doctors are like, just vitamin D, vitamin D, vitamin D.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Beauty gadgets. Yay or nay?
Yay.
What do you use?
I use red light, which I think helps with seasonal depression. I think I have like quite sensitive skin, so I can't use like so much topical stuff. Like, you just feel better. You look better. I put my daughter to bed. She reads me a story. I put
and
on the red light
the
and I feel it's great. Yes.
Aging gracefully, pro or no?
Gracefully with
love
help.
That question.
I think gracefully with help. I think accepting, like you've got to just accept you're getting older and not try to look young because that's like, it's a losing battle.
Yes.
But I think like gracefully with some help is like my motto.
From 1 to 10, how hot do you like your shower water?
8.
Me too. 8,
it's not
8.
good
5.
For you. I know my husband does the Vim Hof like for 3 minutes. And I'm like, I hate you that you can do this. Yeah, he's hardcore. And he really does it even in the winter. And I'm so jealous because I'm sure it's good for you. But
I'm sure it is too. I'm trying as well. So
good luck.
Yeah, you know the procrastination thing?
Yeah.
That's about the Wim Hof? Which I keep thinking, I've got to do it. It's about the brown fat.
Well, that is on
I've heard
my
about, you
never
know,
list.
I have tried in the shower at
Me
the
too.
End just doing the
in
cold.
In the summer. When it's hot.
Yeah, really tough. Yeah. Really tough. Just not into it, but I'm trying to get there. Maybe by the next time we meet.
Let me know how it goes. If you have a hack.
I'm like, no, we will have done it. And she's like, let me know how it goes. And I'm like, no, we're going to do it. Yes, by the next time we see each other, we will have Wim Hof'd.
Okay.
At least 3 times. full dip in something cold.
I hope we don't see each other for a while.
Yeah. Are you married to a particular fragrance or more of a Tinder fragrance type?
Again, I'm a pure, I'm like tuberose all the way.
Oh, so what's your favorite one?
Frock off forever and ever.
Me too.
But then really.
I loved it a long time ago. It actually didn't smell good on me, but I had a bottle of it, the original, because it smelled so good.
And we
had a candle that's a fluorosa candle that smells very similar.
Well, I would love to smell it. But then now I invested in this. One of my good friends has a company called Saint Jardin, which is a really beautiful, super sustainable fragrance brand. And so I invested in it, and I love her tuberose. It's actually the first time I've switched from tuberose.
You're wearing it today, right? Because when I walked in, I could smell tuberose. It was beautiful.
Thank you.
Which beauty items are always on your person?
Your invisible non-lipstick lipstick.
The un-lipstick.
It's so good.
So good.
It's so good because I hate lipstick. Is that Jenna's?
Yeah, Jenna Lyons did those with us.
Oh, I love Jenna. I don't know her, but I think she's just awesome. Totally awesome. Oh, wow. Now I like it even more. Yeah, it's so good because it's like lipstick is so, I feel like it's really aging and it just makes you look like really made up.
Too lipsticky.
Yeah, so I always have that on me. That's really all.
Yeah, I'm lipstick.
Not, like, yeah.
Yeah, please share your most helpful makeup tip. Is it brows?
I mean, I got a lot from Tom, I have to say. He's a beauty expert, and he's always like, because, you know, before we'd go out, like, we'd be from the office, and we'd go out, and he's like, no, just put some of this, like, illuminating primer on over your makeup, and it just sort of wakes everything up, and you're like, oh, wow, that made everything look fresh again, so that was a good one. And then, like, two Coke cans. I don't drink Coke, but, like, two Coke cans on the eyes, like, if you're feeling sort
puffy.
Of puffy or just, like, tired, whatever. It just sort of tightens everything up. So,
okay.
And it works for a minute.
Love it.
And then it all falls apart again.
How do you get into the evening out beauty zone? Bubble bath, killer smoky eye. End of the day, you just need to now you have to go out. What is your one thing that kind of gets you in that mode?
I feel like I'm always running right now. Like I'm like finish work, get the kids like sorted and then like go out. So I don't really have indulgence. I mean, I would love to have a bath before I go out. But I feel like once I have my whole life for that. When the kids are a bit older, I can like
That's
bathe
for other
all
people,
I want.
Yeah. Not entrepreneurs. Bathing? Like what is a bath?
I think some sparkles on the eyes always like over your eye makeup just sort of makes you look a bit festive. Yeah, and like when in doubt, like just a lot of dark eyeliner. Okay. I feel like makes you look moody and dramatic.
Yes, I agree. Actually, a nice smoky eye.
Yeah.
Patty Dubroff did this beautiful smoky eye kit for us, and it's got like the perfect eyeliner and then the perfect palette. And you just put it on, and then you just need like a very neutral glossy lip, and you look like serious about going out.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you kind of only want to wear it when you're serious about going out because you can't wear that in the day. You're just like, whoa, where is she going or where does she think she's going? Advice for your 16-year-old self.
You're better than you think you are because I had so much self-doubt. It's like, I think also just don't compare yourself to other people. Mm. I was like obsessively comparing myself to other people. It's like futile. It's just a waste of time.
Somebody said to me once that comparison is a thief of joy.
So true.
Yeah.
So true. Even like now I think about that all the time. It's like just, I don't even look at what other people are doing. I have so much to worry about myself, and my own game, and my own world, and my own family.
It's kind of great.
Yeah, it is.
That's why I like to stay busy.
It's true.
So I don't have time to look at what anybody else is doing.
Think about it, yeah.
Okay, weirdest treatment you've ever had at a spa?
Colonics, or just disgusting. Like that's with Wim Hof of never doing that again. It's just like awful.
How many pull-ups can you do in a row?
Oh, I don't know. I do a lot of push-ups. I do pull-ups on the Pilates reformer. I haven't done a pull-up in a long time.
All right. Well, we might have to get a pull-up bar in
here. How many can you do?
Oh, none. No way. But when I was, a bodybuilder, which was sort of in my early 20s, I could do 30 pull-ups.
That's
like
insane.
This, which was pretty incredible.
Amazing.
I know. And at my back,
do you have
like
videos
this,
of it?
I have all this muscle. I have some old pictures.
Yeah, that's cool.
I had a six-pack.
Yeah. Well,
it was like
I'm sure
amazing.
You still have one under there.
Yeah, under there.
No, but I mean,
under it, got a lot. Oh, this is a good one. How would you break it to your hairdresser that you need something new?
I see. I wish you would break it to me. I need something new. I feel like.
Oh, so he never.
Yeah, because I'm such a creature of habit.
Hairdresser?
I've got like the color person and the hair, but I feel like I'm sort of like routine girl. You're like, I don't want to be one of those older people that's like, oh, she's still doing that same thing she did in the, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's
like,
sort of out of date.
Stuck in her way. So I feel like I would love someone to be like, you know what would be great on you? And I had Tom who would always do that. He'd be like, why don't you try this? So I feel like I need to probably
mix it up.
Maybe. Oh. Maybe. Well, I don't know. Oh. Try something new.
Well, yeah, I think your hair is great for you.
Well, okay.
But if you ever want someone to look at you in a totally new way, Garen, have you heard of
him? Yeah, of course.
Oh, yeah, of course. Have you ever had your hair cut?
No. Life-changing?
Totally life-changing. I mean, unfortunately, he's in New York.
That's the problem with the maintenance of
but
that.
But once in a while, you go in there, you come out. I mean, strangers will stop you in an elevator and go, great haircut. I remember.
That's amazing.
Oh yeah. Several times after I've had my hair cut by him, I'd have a guy in St. Bart's like pull up on a mini moke and go, great haircut, and then speed away. Or a kid in the airport who was just like surveying.
That's amazing.
People come up and go, great haircut. And you're like, you're just like some 20-year-old kid. What do you know about a great haircut? And they actually comment. So I would highly recommend. He is a total genius. Supplements?
Vitamin D.
Okay.
We've already discussed the importance of vitamin D. Yeah.
Any others?
Omegas.
Yeah, omegas
and
are really important.
Calcium, because we're ladies.
Very
and bones.
Important. Your go-to beauty birthday gift. You're going to give somebody a birthday gift.
Beauty Pie subscription.
That's a really great
I think
answer.
It's a great gift.
It is a great gift. Yeah. Okay, your beauty icons. Tom, obviously. Jenna.
Beauty icons. I think Jenna, Jenna's totally amazing. I love those 60s. Like, I love Twiggy, and I thought she was so beautiful in Jean Shrimpton, and, like, their like, dramatic eyes. Obviously, Audrey Hepburn. Mm. Current beauty icons. I mean, Beyoncé, to me, is just my icon in everything and all beauty.
Yeah, she's amazing.
And womanhood amazing. And motherhood and amazing talent and beauty.
And works so hard.
Yeah, right? Works so hard and keeps getting better. She just keeps, you're like, how did you make that song better? And every time she sings it and performs, you're just like, she's incredible to me.
She's incredible. What is your I'm totally crushing it indicator?
I'm waiting for that.
Well, for now, do you have one?
No, I think when everyone's in harmony, I think when like my family's happy, you know, that you're only as happy as your least happy kid is so true. So I feel like when my family's happy and we're together, that like to me is when I hate it, but like sales are such a like barometer of like how I feel. And you're like, woohoo, we're beating Target. And you're like, this is crazy. I was speaking to Gabriella Hirsch. She's like, my mood's totally determined by my sell through. I'm like, you too? Because it's like so true. You're like, so that makes me feel like I'm crushing it.
Yeah, it's interesting.
It's terrible.
It? You can have a like an off sales day and your whole day can be crushed.
Yeah, it's and that's, terrible.
Yeah, maybe we should not
that's
look
not
every
healthy.
Day.
No, or look every hour or every like.
Oh
half
no, yeah, I don't. I definitely don't look every hour. That would just that. No, you have to. If you're doing that, you stop doing that.
Okay.
Yeah, because there are external forces, right?
I know.
You can look at trends, but if you
no, I know you can't get too bogged down in the like
once a day max. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Right. Okay. Deal.
And maybe at the end of the day, so you can go to sleep instead of worrying about it all day.
That's a great bit of advice. I will take that.
I think I'll take it too. Five must-have Beauty Pie products.
Oh, easy. That cleansing balm is so good.
The
and my daughter is seven and she loves it too. It's
the
like
green
her
one.
Treat.
Or the white one.
The one that turns into liquid on your body. A waxy thing.
Yes.
And
yes.
then you put it on your body, it turns into an oil.
Which color jar?
Clear.
Oh, yeah. It's a super healthy skin. Yeah.
Balm. Oil. Is it? Yeah. It's amazing.
Amazing.
Your hydrolic acid.
Or hyaluronic.
The really strong one.
Yes.
That I use, like, I have to use it like once a week or once or twice a week max. Only because I have sensitive skin. Okay. But it's amazing. It's the only one that's worked for me, actually, because usually they make me break out.
Oh, wow.
Because I'm sensitive.
It's a gut microbiome thing.
Is it?
Yeah.
And lipstick.
Yeah,
and non-lipstick is totally genius. I love your brow.
Yep, brow
pencil. Angled brow pencil. Number five is going to be the brow gel, which I haven't tried, but I'm going to. I'm
we
ordering it.
We also have
it.
To get you, oh, that's the Florosa candle. You will love the Florosa candle. So you're going to leave with that today,
wow,
at least.
Lucky me.
Yeah, because if you love tuberose, it's gorgeous. At Beauty Pie, we believe that overpaying is officially over, so we'd like to know. What things are you officially over and why?
Like high street waste. I think anything environmentally damaging is really officially over. Yep. It's just wrong. Food waste, wrong, over. Waste in general, over. High street, like high street fashion, wear once, you buy for 10 pounds, over. Done. I don't even know why that even happened. Well, we know why it happened, but done.
Done.
Yeah.
Excellent. Thanks for watching and we'll see you soon.